Psalm 27 verses 1 to 3 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident." Spiritual warfare is a very real and significant aspect of Christian life. Throughout the Bible, God has given His people tools for protection, encouragement, and victory in the face of spiritual attacks. The Bible makes it clear that spiritual warfare is not against flesh and blood, but against the powers of darkness and spiritual forces in heavenly realms. This truth sets the foundation for our understanding that the battles we face are often spiritual in nature. The Psalms, written by King David and other worshippers, show how we can trust in God, who is our shield and fortress in the face of these battles. In this context, we can use the Psalms to stand firm in the face of spiritual attacks, declaring God's promises over our lives and those around us. Do well to subscribe to this channel for prayers tailored just for you on this channel. Let's pray. I declare over you that the Psalms are weapons for spiritual warfare, filled with promises of God's protection and presence during times of trouble, in Jesus' name. As you speak and pray these Psalms over your life, may you find strength, comfort, and victory in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 is perhaps one of the most powerful declarations of God's protection in the Bible. It speaks of divine shelter, security, and the assurance that no harm will come to those who trust in God. Psalm 91 verses 1 to 4 say, "Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart." I declare over you that you dwell in the shelter of the Most High, and you are safe in the shadow of the Almighty in Jesus' name. The Lord is your refuge and fortress, and no weapon formed against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Spiritual attacks may come, but God will save you from every snare and protect you from every harm. His faithfulness will be your shield, and His presence will be your covering. Psalm 91 verses 11 to 12 says, "For He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." I declare over you that angels are on assignment to protect you from harm. The Lord will keep you from stumbling, and no evil will befall you in Jesus' name. Every trap set by the enemy will be dismantled, and you will walk in victory in Jesus' name. The Lord Himself will be your shield, and you will be delivered from every spiritual attack in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 23 is another well-loved psalm that speaks of God's cares and provision in times of trouble. The imagery of God as a shepherd is a beautiful reminder of His protective nature. A shepherd guards his flock, leading them to safety, providing for them and fighting off predators. Psalm 23 verses 1 to 4 says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths. For His name's sake, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me." I declare over you that the Lord is your shepherd, and you lack nothing. Even in the darkest valleys, even in the midst of spiritual attacks, you will fear no evil. God's presence is with you, guarding you, protecting you, and comforting you. His rod and staff will fight off every enemy that rises against you in Jesus' name. This psalm also emphasizes that a shepherd will prepare a table for you in the presence of your enemies, and he will anoint your head with oil, signifying his protection and favor. This is a declaration that no spiritual attack will prosper because the Lord Himself fights for you. Psalm 23 verse 5 says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows." I declare over you that even in the presence of your enemies, the Lord will provide for you. You will eat at his table, and your enemies will not harm you. Your head is anointed with the oil of his favor and protection, and your cup of blessings will overflow. No matter what the enemy tries to bring against you, God has already made you victorious in Jesus' name. Psalm 27 speaks of God as our light and salvation, declaring that we need not fear any enemy because God is our stronghold. This psalm is a bold declaration of confidence in the Lord, even in the face of spiritual attacks and adversity. I declare over you that the Lord is your light and your salvation. You will not fear any spiritual attack or adversary that comes against you. Though the enemy may rise against you, they will stumble and fall in Jesus' name. God is your stronghold, and you will stand firm in the face of any spiritual battle. This psalm also encourages us to seek the presence of the Lord, for in his presence there is safety and security. The psalmist expresses a desire to dwell in the house of the Lord and seek his face, for in his presence enemies cannot prevail. Psalm 27 verses 4 to 5 say, "One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock." I declare over you that in the day of trouble the Lord will hide you in his presence in Jesus' name. He will lift you high upon a rock, far above the reach of your enemies. As you seek his face, you will find safety and deliverance from every spiritual attack in Jesus' name. Psalm 34 is a declaration of God's deliverance. This psalm teaches us that God is near to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. It reminds us that the righteous may face many troubles, but the Lord delivers them from them all. Psalm 34 verse 4 to 7 say, "I sought the Lord and he answered. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and he delivers them." I declare over you that the Lord hears your prayers, and he will deliver you from all your fears. Whatever troubles you are facing, know that God will deliver you from them all. His angels surround you, and they will protect you from every spiritual attack. You will not be put to shame, for the Lord is your defender and deliverer. This psalm also speaks of the righteousness that comes from seeking the Lord. Those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways will experience his goodness and protection. The Lord watches over his people and delivers them from every danger. Psalm 34 verses 17 to 19 says, "The righteous cry out and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all." I declare over you that no matter what troubles you face, the Lord will deliver you from them all in Jesus' name. He is close to you in your brokenness, and he will save you from every spiritual attack. You are righteous in his sight, and he will protect you and keep you safe. Psalm 121 is a psalm of ascents, declaring that God is our help and keeper. This psalm reassures us that God never slumbers nor sleeps. He is always watching over his people and guarding them against all harm and every spiritual attacks of the enemies. I declare that God will guide and keep you against every form of spiritual attacks in your life in Jesus' name. Psalm 27 verse 1 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" May you find comfort in these words, knowing that God is your light, shining brightly even in the darkest of times. He is your salvation, delivering you from all harm. May you stand strong, unafraid of the challenges that lie ahead, because God is the stronghold of your life. There is no need to fear when God is your protector. Verse 2 of Psalm 27 says, "When the wicked advanced against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall." I pray that as the enemy tries to advance against you, they will stumble and fall. May every plan of the wicked be thwarted, every scheme against you be dismantled. May those who rise up against you see their plans crumble. As God stands as a shield around you, protecting you from every assault. Verse 3 says, "Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war breaks out against me, even then I will be confident." I pray that you remain fearless, even when it seems like you are surrounded on all sides. May your confidence be rooted in the Lord, knowing that He is your defender. In the face of overwhelming odds, may you stand firm, unshaken by the battles raging around you, because you trust in God's ability to fight for you. It is written in Psalm 27, verse 4, "One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him in His temple." May your deepest desire be to dwell in God's presence, where you find peace and strength. In His house, may you gaze upon His beauty, finding comfort and reassurance in His steadfast love. As you seek Him, may He draw near to you, filling you with His peace that surpasses all understanding. Verse 5 says, "For in the day of trouble He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of His sacred tent and set me high upon a rock." In every day of trouble, I pray that God keeps you safe in your dwelling, hiding you under the shadow of His wings, where no harm can reach you. May God set you high upon a rock, a place of stability and safety far above the reach of your enemies. Let this be your refuge, where you are secure in His protection. Psalm 27 verse 6, "Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At His sacred tent I will sacrifice with shouts of joy, and I will sing and make music to the Lord." I pray that as God fights your battles, He will lift up your head above your enemies. May you experience the joy of victory as you see God's hands at work in your life. May your response be one of praise and thanksgiving as you offer sacrifices of joy to the Lord. Sing and make music to God, celebrating the deliverance He brings. Psalm 27 verses 7 to 8 says, "Hear my voice when I call, Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says of you, seek His face. Your face, Lord, I will seek." I pray that as you call out to God, He will hear your voice and be merciful to you. May your heart be drawn to seek His face, for in seeking Him, you find the strength and courage needed to face your battles. May this be a time of deepening your relationship with God as you rely on Him more and more, in Jesus' name. Psalm 27 verse 9 says, "Do not hide from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger, for you have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me, God, my Savior." I pray that you always feel the nearness of God's presence. Do not let fear or doubt cause you to feel abandoned, for God is your helper and your Savior. He will not reject or forsake you, but will stand by your side through every trial. May you trust in His unfailing love and faithfulness. According to Psalm 27 verses 10 to 11, "Though my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors." Even if those closest to you turn away, may you know that God will always receive you. He is your constant companion, never leaving your side. May He teach you His ways, leading you in a straight path, free from the traps and snares of your oppressors. May God's wisdom guide you, keeping you on the path of righteousness. Psalm 27 verse 12, "Do not turn me over to the desires of my foes, for false witnesses rise up against me, spouting malicious accusations." I pray that you will be protected from the desires of your foes. Do not let false witnesses or malicious accusations have any power over you. May God's truth be your shield, defending you from every lie and deceit. May you stand firm in your integrity, knowing that God is your defender. Psalm 27 verses 13 to 14 says, "I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord." May you remain confident in God's goodness. Believe that you will see His victory in your life, even now and in the land of the living. As you wait for the Lord, may your heart be strengthened. Take heart and be courageous, knowing that God's timing is perfect and His plan for you is good. Wait patiently for Him, trusting that He is working all things for your good. Lord Jesus, you are the stronghold of my life. Even when dark shadows are cast upon me, I shall not fear. For you protect me from evildoers and those who try to destroy me. Lord, when my adversaries and foes rise against me, let them stumble and fall down flat, never to rise again. And when an innumerable host of armies encamp against me and I have no way out, help me to be confident and strong in you. For you are my mighty fortress and you will give me victory. According to the words of verses 4 and 5, one thing I have asked of the Lord that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For he will hide me in his shelter in the day of trouble. He will conceal me under the cover of his tent. He will lift me high upon a rock. Heavenly Father, there's nothing I would want more than to dwell in your house forever, not just me, but my entire household, so that we can keep gazing at the beauty that comes from you alone. Lord, please hide us in your shelter in the day of trouble. I know that when things get tough in life, you will be there to protect me. When I am most vulnerable and storms arise and my circumstances are out of control, you will lift me high upon a rock. According to the words of verses 6 and 7, and now my head shall be lifted up above my enemies all around me, and I will offer in his tent sacrifices with shouts of joy. I will sing and make a melody to the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud. Be gracious to me and answer me. You have said, seek my face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. O Redeemer of my soul, I need you to lift my head above all the enemies surrounding me all around, and cause me to rejoice and offer you shouts of joy and thanksgiving. Please hear my cry as I cry aloud to you. You told me to seek your face. I am seeking your face and pursuing you with all that I have. Forgive me for my inadequacies and sinful tendencies to ignore you. Help me and save me, my Lord. According to the words of verses 8 to 11, my heart says to you, your face, Lord, do I seek. Hide not your face from me. Turn not your servant away in anger. O you who have been my help, cast me not off. Forsake me not, O God of my salvation. Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me on the level path because of my enemies. Everlasting Father, do not hide your face from me. I have come to seek your face for strength. I know I am imperfect and I've done some things that can make you turn away from me in anger. Please forgive me, for I have no other person to run to other than you. Please help me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Please be my rock and my redeemer. I ask you to please be my comforter during the times of stress. Teach me your ways and lead me on a level path. You are a lamp to my feet. Guide me and direct me away from the ambushes the enemy has planned for me, and give me courage and the wisdom to overcome their wicked schemes. According to the words of verses 12 to 14, give me not up to the will of my adversaries, for false witnesses have risen against me and they breathe out violence. I believe that I shall look upon the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong, and let your hearts take courage. Wait for the Lord. Lord, please do not give me to the will of my adversaries. They have vile in their mouth and their heart. Do not wish me well. They have false witnesses against me. They want to see me fall and cry. But I look to your goodness, my Lord and King. I will wait on you, and I will be strong and not let my heart grow weak. Because with you by my side, I will climb over walls and triumph over their evil deeds. Lord, I know you have already given proof to my prayers, and now I have what it takes to take on giant. According to Psalm 68 verse 1, may God arise, may his enemies be scattered, may his foes flee before him. I ask that you rise in your power and scatter every adversity that stands against us. May your presence cause our enemies to retreat. I pray that you dissolve the wicked schemes like smoke dissipating in the wind. I affirm that the plans of the wicked crumble for your consuming fire, and may they perish in their own devices, as stated in Psalm 68 verse 2. May you blow them away like smoke, as wax melts before the fire. May the wicked perish before God. May I find joy in your righteousness, taking delight in your presence, as Psalm 68 verse 3 encourages. But may the righteous be glad and rejoice rejoice before God. May they be happy and joyful. I pray that you lead me out of the bondage of fear and anxiety, filling my heart with the joy of salvation. May I find comfort and freedom in every area of my life where I need it. I declare that you go before me in every venture, and no harm shall befall me as I journey through the wilderness of life. May I be guided by your presence and protected from every danger that lies ahead. I declare that your enemies will stumble and fall before you, as stated in Psalm 27 verse 2. When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Their plans to harm you will crash, according to Psalm 27 verse 3. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident. Even in the face of overwhelming odds, may you not fear, but find confidence in the power and faithfulness of the Father. May you always stand firm, knowing that the Lord is with you. May you dwell securely in his presence, beholding his beauty and never losing wonder of him. Even if dark shadows loom, you shall not be moved, for the Lord is your stronghold, protecting you from evildoers. I pray that in times of trouble, you find refuge in the Lord's dwelling, as mentioned in Psalm 27 verse 5. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of a sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. May you remain hidden from your enemies in the shelter of his presence. I declare that your adversaries stand no chance against you. For the Lord is your shield, covering you with his presence. May you be lifted up on the rock of salvation above the forces that seek to harm you. Just as the psalmist in Psalm 27 verse 6 said, then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. I declare that you are exalted above your surrounding enemies. May your heart be filled with joy, offering sacrifices of praise and thanksgiving in the presence of the Father. I pray that in times of distress, the Lord's grace and mercy intercede on your behalf. May your heart remain steadfast on the Father as your rock, finding comfort and strength in his love and grace. May the Lord's light continue to shine upon you, keeping you secure in his love. In Psalm 68 verse 17, it states, the chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. The Lord is among them. As in Sinai, in the holy place, I pray that a multitude of angels surround you, providing protection and guidance. May the presence of the Lord fill your heart with courage and confidence, knowing that he fights on your behalf. Psalm 68 verse 19 says, blessed be the Lord, who daily loadeth us with the benefits, even the God of our salvation. I pray that your needs are met daily, and that you receive continual grace and favor. May every burden weighing you down be lifted, and may you be released from the grip of death. Let the salvation of the Lord your God be your shield and refuge, according to Psalm 68 verse 21. But God shall wound the head of his enemies, and the airy scalp of such as one that goeth on still in his trespasses. I pray that the Lord rises up and brings justice upon your enemies. May every wicked scheme be exposed and defeated, and may God's righteousness prevail over everyone who rebels against you. Psalm 68 verse 22 declares, the Lord said, I will bring again from Bashan, I will bring my people again from the depths of the sea. I declare restoration and deliverance in every area of your life. May the hand of the Lord guide you safely through every trial and tribulation. Amidst uncertainties and challenges, I pray that you hold fast to the truth that the Lord is your light in darkness and your salvation in times of trouble. In Jesus' name, may your confidence never waver in the unfailing love of the Father, who is your fortress, even in the face of adversaries and trials, as the psalmist declared in Psalm 27 verse 3. In times of adversity, may you find courage to remain rooted in the knowledge of the Lord's power and presence. May you trust in the perfect timing and sovereign control of the Lord over every situation in your life, understanding the times and seasons in Jesus' name. I lift up your families, homes, and communities before the Lord, praying for divine protection over them. May the Lord lead you on paths shielded from the snares of the enemy and the moments of weakness. May you find strength in the Lord, your ever-present help. As affirmed by the psalmist in Psalm 27 verse 13, may you continue to believe in the goodness of the Father, even in challenging times, and may you have discernment to recognize and resist the schemes of the enemy, as prayed by the psalmist in Psalm 27 verse 12. In Psalm 68 verse 17, it is stated, "The chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. The Lord is amongst them, as in Sinai in the holy place." I pray for the multitude of angels to surround you, offering protection and guidance. May the presence of the Lord fill your heart with courage and confidence, knowing that He fights on your behalf. According to Psalm 68 verse 19, "Blessed be the Lord who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the God of our salvation." I pray that your daily needs are met abundantly in Jesus' name. I ask for continual grace and favor to be upon you. I pray for the burdens weighing heavily on your shoulders to be lifted, and for the grip of death to be released from your life. May the salvation of the Lord be your shield and refuge, providing safety and security. I pray for divine justice to be brought upon your enemies, as stated in Psalm 68 verse 21. "But God shall wound the head of his enemies, and the airy scalp of such that goeth on stealing his trespasses." May every wicked schemes be exposed and defeated, and may God's righteousness prevail over all who oppose you. According to Psalm 68 verse 22, the Lord said, "I will bring again from Bashan, I will bring my people again from the depths of the sea. I declare restoration and deliverance in every area of your life." May the hand of the Lord be upon you, guiding you safely through every trial and tribulation. I declare the Lion of Judah stands guard, defending you. The Lord will surround you with his angel armies. They will keep you safe and secured in Christ despite raging storms. Remember that these present sufferings are but birth pangs, ushering into great reward up ahead as you remain faithful. I decree divine strategies and insights revealing the hidden hand empowering attacks against you, according to Psalm 59 verse 10. "My God in his steadfast love will meet me. God will let me look in triumph on my enemies." Ask the Holy Spirit to unveil all adversaries, agendas, legal rights, and demonic weapons formed against you. God sees and knows all and has already ordained their defeat. I command every hidden adversary orchestrating chaos, loss, and delay against you to be caught in their own craftiness and schemes. Like a man, may they fall under the weight of their own devices. No evil will prevail against you. These storms manifest the very breakthroughs and blessings they sought to hinder. Glory to God. I call forth legions of angels to enforce these righteous decrees and divine restraining orders against demonic interference in your life, family, finances, health, and ministry endeavors, according to Psalm 103 verses 20 to 22. May they heed God's word, establishing protective boundaries around all he has ordained for you, to guard it in Jesus' name against enemy assault, so that no weapon prevails. Beloved child of the Most High, when darkness and turmoil tempt you to question where God is in all this, remember, our helper remains closer than a brother. The Holy Spirit strengthens, guides, and comforts within. His presence in you is greater than any force the enemy wields against you. Take heart and stand. I declare with joy that the Lord turns curses into blessings over those who love him and call upon his name. Where others revile, he speaks only goodness and favor into your destiny. No curse can overtake you. No witch can withstand his cleansing blood. Rejoice in him. I decree we serve a God who routs enemies with a shout. At the blast of your battle cry, O Lord, every enemy stronghold threatening your child crumbles now to dust. Surround them with favor as with a shield. May all the adversaries be scattered and in panic, chaos, and confusion against the roar of the Lion of Judah. I command all adversarial soldiers armed by demonic realm against you to drop weapon right now under the authority of Christ, according to Luke 9 verse 1.
Receive power and authority over every demon-aspired assignment, seeking your downfall or demise, whether originating from strangers, family, close friends, employers, or pastors. It shall not succeed. Call upon angels to enforce their immediate disarming and removal from proximity in Jesus' name. I call forth divine turnaround against every weapon and serpentine tactic of the enemy according to Isaiah 54 verse 17. No weapon that is fashioned against you shall succeed, and you shall refute every tongue that arises against you in judgment. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their vindication from me, declares the Lord. Beloved saints washed in Christ's blood, you have been given everything pertaining to life and godliness. Through intimacy with God, our defense grows impenetrable against all fear, intimidation, and adversary threats seeking compromise or control. Abide in the shelter of his wing. There the enemy holds no ground. I declare with boldness and authority, perfect love, which casts out all tormenting fear. Through Christ, we dismantle every weapon of deception, accusation, oppression, seeking to manipulate our behavior. His grace empowers us to walk in freedom as sons and daughters of the living God. No more cowering before darkness. All power rests in his hands. I decree that no shame or weapon from hell can separate you from God's all-encompassing love. Despite raging storms, hold tightly to this truth. Trials and persecutions serve to strengthen you as overcomer, displaying his victory more brightly. Through intimacy with Christ, you shine as lamps upon a hill, pushing back encroaching shadows. Rejoice in the Lord always. His banner over you is love. I command all familiar spirits attached to generational iniquities and traumas to release you now in Jesus' mighty name. Receive freedom from oppressive soul ties, narcissistic abuse, substance addictions, poverty mindset, and infirmities passed down through bloodline. Walk in the light as Christ is light. No darkness can overtake or overwhelm those who walk in righteousness, truth, and intimacy with God. I call forth shining angels to cut cords of parasitic manipulation and control forged through ungodly soul ties. According to Hebrews 1 verse 14, receive deep spiritual cleansing by the blood of Jesus Christ that sets all captives free. Break all agreements made by coercion or deceit. Revoke permission to sustain this access. Be free from physical and sexual and emotional abuses that open doors to further defilement and darkness. The Lord raises up a standard against every enemy and oppressor in your life by the word of his power. Saints washed in Christ's redeeming blood, never forget all enemies live eternally defeated under his feet. Despite raging storms and adversary threats in the natural world, just as David numbered enemy plunder before battle's end in faith, so too we call for things not yet seen. Though fools boast and intimidate through worldly display of powers, God laughs knowing he has already ordained both their folly and their fall. I declare with joy that sorrow lasts only for a night, but overwhelming victory comes with the dawning of his light. What enemy means for evil, God hijacks, turning your favor when you love and trust him. In due time, every adversary will lift their heads in worship, declaring his lordship. Stand unwavering upon this eternal truth. I decree spiritual highways of the ungodly open to enemy access now, closed forever by Christ's blood. Receive deep deliverance from deception, defilement, and oppression through generational weakness exploited by evil spirits. Walk into divine destiny with fresh vision, spiritual integrity, and kingdom purpose. The redeemed of the Lord shall return and come with singing unto Zion in Jesus' name. I command all adversarial spirits charged with assignments of premature death, destruction, family chaos, poverty, sickness, accidents, betrayal, and the like to bow before the eternal power and purposes of Almighty God in your life right now. Whether empowered through personal sin, trauma, generational curses, or deceit, I declare that no weapon formed against God's beloved shall prosper. Receive breakthrough. I call forth divine reversal. I call forth divine reversal of every curse sent your way. Just as Balak sought enchantments against God's people, today sorcerers and death wishes become prophetic blessings. So I declare that you receive superabundant harvests. May every enemy live to see the goodness of God manifest powerfully in your life. Their plans cannot prevail against Jehovah's will. Hallelujah. Rise up, child of God. What the enemy uses to taunt and intimidate will become his undoing. Know that through intimacy, obedience, and surrender, that God ordains your step, securing triumph every single time. He goes ahead preparing the way, trusting His great love, which casts out all fear. No darkness prevails against His marvelous light and sovereign plans. You are more than a conqueror through Christ. I declare the enemy condemned and rendered powerless through weaponized fear, intimidation, and controlling manipulation, according to Isaiah 50 verse 9. Receive freedom from people-pleasing and codependency that allows others to determine value or mood through worldly praise or criticisms. The Lord alone is your vindicator and help. Set your heart only unto Him. I decree the Psalms 91 protection covenant activated over your life today. As you make the Most High God your habitation, He sends angels to guard you in all ways. Safety, deliverance from every snare, and provision are your inheritance as a beloved child of God. Abide in faith and confidence no matter what comes against you. He is faithful to defend, strengthen, and establish those who take refuge under His wing. I command all thieves of peace and joy to release you now in Jesus' name. Depart from this child of God, all you spirits of deception, disappointment, offense, depression, and heaviness seeking doors through unmet expectations. Go receive supernatural comfort and perspective from the Holy Spirit. I declare that God is your salvation and fortress against every unjust enemy. As David prayed after being pursued relentlessly by Saul, I pray God confuses and confounds those who want to attack and accuse you without reason. In the mighty name of Jesus, He will scatter them with His power, blow them away as dust in the wind. May their paths be dark and slippery as angel armies chase them down. I pray for God's supernatural intervention, just as He rescued righteous Lot from the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. He will rain down His judgment on the unjust as He did with Sodom, turning their plans to folly. He will guide you safely through fiery trials as He did with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and bring you out unharmed in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord God promises that He will maintain our cause. So I ask that God Almighty will rise as divine judge on your behalf. He will awake and rise to your defense. He will contend with those contending against you. As Elisha prayed for his servant's eyes to be opened in 2 Kings verse 6, He will open your eyes to see the armies of heaven surrounding you. He will remind you that those with you are far greater than those coming to attack. If there are accusers plotting secretly or setting traps with hidden snares like David's enemy Saul, I pray God will expose their schemes and lies. May their traps and pits become their own doing. As a man's plot was turned back on his own head in the book of Esther, cause the nets they hid to cut them instead. Let them fall to their own destruction in Jesus' name. I stand in the victory of Christ that says, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. I say, greater is He living within you than any forces that could come to harm you. I decree that God sends confusion into the camp of your enemies. May those planning to pursue you stumble in the dark, unable to find you. The armies of heaven intercept any attacks or sabotage from your enemies. They will surround you with walls of fire, hide you supernaturally from those wishing to falsely accuse or attack without cause. In this sacred moment, I call upon Jesus, our judge and counselor, to not only protect you, but also provide you with divine guidance and wisdom. I pray that Abba Father give you the spirit of discernment to navigate the intricate webs of deception that surrounds you. Just as Solomon sought his wisdom in 1 Kings chapter 3 verses 5 to 14, I decree the same divine insight in the mighty name of Jesus. The rose of Sharon, just like Solomon, bow in humility before your throne. I acknowledge my dependence on your wisdom, understanding that my own reasoning falls short in deciphering of the schemes of those who act unjustly. I pray that He will mastermind the destruction of the enemies on your behalf. I beseech God to illuminate your mind with the brilliance of His truth. I pray, grant you the spirit to discern and recognize the right path amidst the labyrinth of deceit woven by your enemies. May his wisdom be your guiding compass, leading you through the maze of injustice in Jesus' name. In this moment of prayer, God, I surrender our limited understanding, trusting in your infinite wisdom. Envelope us in the clarity of your counsel, that we may discern between right and wrong, justice and injustice. May your wisdom fortify your child against the deceptive strategies of those who oppose your child in the mighty name of Jesus. I lean on God's guidance, and I decree that his wisdom become a guiding light, piercing through the darkness of deception against you in Jesus' name. He will strengthen you with the assurance that in his divine counsel, you possess the discernment needed to overcome the craftiness of your adversaries. May the Lord grant you wisdom as you defeat unjust enemies, empowering you to walk in righteousness and ensuring your steps to align with his divine purpose. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, forgive us for harboring unforgiveness and bitterness against those coming against your child. We choose to love, bless, and pray for our enemies as you commanded. I pray that you grant your child the strength to overcome evil with good in Jesus' mighty name. Reveal your heart of compassion towards them so that they too may be saved. And as I stand battling in prayer and believing for your help, I wait expectantly for your salvation. In faith, may your child taste and see that you are good. May your child be happy with you. May your child be delighted in you and in your righteousness and shout for joy. The mouth of your child will overflow with praise, for you bring your child safely through every storm. I proclaim your goodness now and forevermore in the life of your child. I pray the promises of Psalm 18 over your life, unleashing the armies of heaven to fight on your behalf, granting supernatural deliverance from every enemy, threat, and adversity. Trust the Lord at all times to come to your defense. Take heart and stand unwavering. Your victory is assured in Christ. I declare the Lord himself as your rock, fortress, and deliverer according to Psalm 18 verse 2. Run to him for refuge when enemies surround and chaos swirls. Find shelter safe beneath his wings where no danger or trouble can reach you. He shall cover you and hide you in the secret place where the Most High dwells. Abide and overcome. I command every enemy threat coming against you to bow its knees to the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our King, right now, according to Philippians 2 verse 10. Through intimacy with God and surrender to his will, access the infinite power and authority of Christ within to dismantle strongholds and cast down high things exalting themselves against the glory due his name. Greater works shall you do because he is risen. I call forth warrior angels to enforce and establish angelic protection around the clock against retaliation from releasing these prayers according to Psalm 91 and Daniel 10 verse 13. Surround God's people with guardians commissioned by heaven to shield night and day. Intercept enemy surveillance and assignments of chaos, destruction, affliction, delay, accusation, deception, sickness, bankruptcy, and death in Jesus' mighty name. No weapon fashioned shall prosper against God's beloved. Beloved saint, God sees your weeping and records every tear in his bottle of remembrance. According to Psalm 56 verse 8, he remains close to the brokenhearted. Take courage. Your morning night of adversity will suddenly explode with joy and reward that is appearing. Stand confident on his promises, though enemies surround, but the battle belongs to the Lord. In due time, he shall silence and disperse those who rise against you, so you may dwell safely in the land of the living to declare his wondrous works according to Psalm 118 verse 17. I decree supernatural turnaround against every weapon and accusation summoned from hell to harm you according to Isaiah 54 verse 15 and Psalm 91. Right here, right now, every evil curse, enchantment, and word declaration backfires and fails. I declare that every sorcery intended for evil reverses into explosive blessing instead. Divine favor surrounds you suddenly with a blessing everywhere you go in Jesus' name. Stand confident, beloved. The Lord Himself goes forth to vindicate and fight for you against those who oppose. I command spirits of oppression, depression, deception, identity theft, untimely death, destruction, corruption, sickness, and lack to flee from you now in Jesus' name. Receive your breakthrough over every stronghold and chain. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4, the anointing breaks every yoke of bondage in Jesus' name. Press forward boldly to apprehend all Jesus Christ secured at the cross on your behalf. Every promise, yes and amen. Walk in freedom, wholeness and abundance prepared for you. As Ezekiel 37 declares, I call forth waves of Holy Spirit breakthrough to turn captivity into victory this day. That which opposed you now fuels acceleration into divine destiny. Move from surviving into thriving. Launch new ventures and sow creativity where lack once overwhelmed. Find joy and wholeness in Christ abundantly, replacing feelings stuck, broken, or defeated. Receive truth and love. Set the captives free. What enemy wickedly devised against you boomerang suddenly for good, life, and redemption. So rejoice, for your hour of breakthrough is now. Psalm 18 verses 30 to 50 shows us that our sovereign God holds time and eternity in His hands, shaping outcomes to conform to His will. Hence, we will walk in partnership from victory ground already sealed by redemptive blood. I declare that you will henceforth trust the Waymaker. Every of your prayers sown hastens that day of awakening, deliverance, and reward assured. Your labor bears eternal fruit as salvation comes to many. Keep proclaiming freedom until earth rings with the knowledge of His glory. Greater is He who lives within. I decree angelic shield to establish supernatural protection around your gates of influence, family, relationships, health, finance, ministry, destiny. According to Psalm 91, may warrior angels bar every enemy and weapon formed against you from accessing what God has ordained for your good. Surround this child day and night, O Lord. Guard their life and calling against destruction, accusation, delays, sickness, lack, affliction, calamity, and untimely death. Give your angels charge over them to keep them in all their ways. I command spirits conjuring confusion, distraction, oppression, and despair through spells and manipulation to now be bound from their assignments and rendered deaf, mute, and impotent in Jesus' mighty name. I declare these tactics exposed by fire and stripped from the demonic architects who now flee in terror, according to Zechariah 5 verse 4. May the curses and false burdens they crafted boomerang suddenly against their kingdom of darkness sevenfold. No more delay to destiny's delivery in Jesus' mighty name. Every weapon and accusation of hell dissolves against His magnificent supremacy and finished work at Calvary on your behalf. Abide securely in your identity as an heir of His salvation, seated with Christ in the heavenly realms. Always remember that greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. By virtue of this knowledge, triumph over every spirit opposing your destiny through intimate worship and declaring His word. God hastens to perform it on behalf of His beloved. No power thrives separated from Christ's love inside you. So rejoice, for God intercedes and advocates for you. I seal this prayer in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, the one who has purchased our eternal salvation and deliverance from every enemy, threat, and adversity. I declare that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, according to Isaiah 54 verse 17, but you shall refute every tongue that rises against you in judgment. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their vindication from me, declares the Lord. I seal the promises of Psalm 18 over your life by the blood of the Lamb. Greater is He who lives within you than he that is in the world. Victory is yours through intimacy with Christ. Walk into your destiny and purpose free from hindrance or delay. The Lord goes before you to fight on your behalf. He is your rear guard protecting behind. I declare those words sealed over you in Jesus' mighty and eternal name. I decree supernatural reversal manifest against every satanic ambush and conspiracy set to hinder God's anointed, according to Isaiah 54 verses 15 and 17. I pray that all sorcery backfires, converting curses into blessing, according to Genesis 12 verse 3 and Numbers 23 verse 23. Receive heavenly strategies, releasing recompense, vindication, restoration, and sevenfold justice against all adversary attacks. Divine turnaround belongs to you, beloved. Stand confident and assured victory comes. Through intimacy and surrender, we access resurrection power that renders enemies defenseless. Drink deep of the infallible spirit of counsel and might. Rise up in ferocious faith, tearing down strongholds and high things exalting themselves against the true knowledge of God. You shall do valiantly through Christ who strengthens you. I call forth warrior angels to ensure full execution of these prayer decrees now, according to Psalm 103 verse 20. And I compel adversary spirits bound for show to obey in Jesus' name. I pray that Abba Father will surround you with angel armies, enforcing protection as decreed under divine counsel in heaven. May all counterattacks, assignments, and weapons dissolve immediately against those hidden in Christ. The Lord will defend and shield you according to the word in Jesus' name. Your authority in prayer avails much through humility and surrender to Christ within you, according to James 5 verse 16. Never underestimate the power in binding and loosing all weapons of declaration wielded in partnership with the Spirit of Might. He responds with reinforcement as we cry out to Him who is mighty to save. Be strong and courageous. Only stand still and see His victory. I decree a mighty wall of angelic protection fortified around you now, so no satanic assault penetrates, according to Zechariah 2 verse 5. I pray Yahweh encamps legions as fiery wall and shield against enemy attack or retaliation. He will give His angels charge over all that pertains to you. Trust Him to guard your life, family, reputation, health, finance, relationships, ministry, endeavors, and emotional stability. In far greater measure than earthly military could provide, may fierce intimidation and accusations dissolve under weight of unfailing love that casts out all torment. Grace triumph over judgments for all hidden in the Most High. Hallelujah! I command spirits of worthlessness, rejection, depression, anger, deception, suicidal thoughts, sickness, confusion, and oppression to lose God's beloved now in Jesus' name. Receive healing streams pouring life and boldness into weary souls, according to Ezekiel 47 verses 1 to 12. Break all agreements made with death and false shelter offered through substance abuse, ungodly soul ties, sexual sin, or escapism. Receive new wineskins to contain the new wine Holy Spirit pours. Set up stones of remembrance, declaring your deliverance this day, never to be imprisoned by former mindsets again. Reckon yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus' name. Arise and go free in the power and authority Christ purchased. I call forth vindication upon all adversaries who plot and scheme, believing their counsel hidden, according to Micah 2 verse 1, Psalm 83 verse 3, and Isaiah 29 verse 15. Reveal the hearts of those cursed, conjuring deception, or seeking to entrap your child. May their attacks and hatred turn to favor instead, according to Genesis 50 verse 20. I release those operating under mind control now from ungodly soul ties and generational strongholds in Jesus' name. Receive through healing, deliverance, and restoration. I break deception's veil with kindness, truth, Calvary's true freedom not yet understood in Jesus' powerful name. Though darkness confronts, lift up your gaze higher, beloved. God meets those who endure the crucible of refinement and wait expectantly upon Him. He remains a sovereign, discerner of hearts, and just judge over all intentions and motives in both earthly and heavenly realms. No accusation prospers before your Father and Redeemer. As you abide patiently under His mighty hand, allow it access to grace, enabling you to stand in goodness and integrity. He will defend and vindicate you in perfect time. No one can stop His destined will for those who love Him and are called according to His purpose. You are already victorious and more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. I decree divine intervention to descend and unlock victory against long-standing generational curses of cancer, sickness, incest, early death, addiction, barrenness, poverty, and lack in Jesus' name. I command DNA restored to wholeness through generational lines. Receive fresh fire flowing in your bloodline, awakening and restoring all crooked places from iniquity of forefathers. May your children, grandchildren, and extended family receive breakthroughs extending for generations to come. Freedom's fire will be released now according to Galatians 5 verse 1. Inherit blessing prepared for you. I command all legal rights, footholds, and access gained through sin or obedience that keep enemy, accusation, and attack empowered to now close forever, be erased by the blood of Jesus. Receive deep deliverance from defilement, deception, and corruption. According to Colossians 1 verse 13, I call forth mighty breakthrough and eternal reward upon your years of unnamed toil and suffering. According to Psalm 126 and Galatians 6 verse 9 and Hebrews 12, 1-3. May generational oppression, lack, sickness, and fruitlessness now dissolve suddenly under an open heaven. Receive acceleration, restoration, and recompense meeting you at every turn. Whereas you have been forgotten, forsaken, and devalued in your past seasons, now royalty and honor mark your every step through double portion inheritance and overcoming anointing activated this day. Your progress unlocks destinies for multitudes. Emmanuel, God is indeed with you, friend. No longer will you cower under threats of enemy or wince at words of past aggressors. Fear is demolished from your bloodline as lion-hearted courage in Christ fuels your every step. With integrity, purpose, and passion, arise to call forth life from death and freedom to captive ones still bound. Take your place as kingdom ambassador, seated firmly in Christ's authority and worth. We worship and exalt you, Lord, for answering all these prayers in Jesus' name. I pray for you now, calling upon the name of our Lord Jesus as I break every scheme of the enemy aimed at harming you. I declare that no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. And I decree that every lying tongue that rises up against you shall be condemned in Jesus' name. All evil arrows sent your way, I send back to the senders in the mighty name of Jesus. Just as David prayed in Psalm 7, asking God to rise up in anger against his enemies and awake for him. May the violence of the wicked bring them down by their own evil intent. I call forth divine judgment on those who secretly shoot arrows of perversity, deceit, and accusations your way. I decree that their traps which they have laid will catch up with them instead in Jesus' name. I declare over your life the promises of Psalm 37. That evildoers shall be cut off, but those who hope in the Lord shall inherit the land. I command every enemy that comes against you to stumble and fall, expire and be no more. Just as David prayed boldly in Psalm 57, asking the Almighty to break the teeth of liars and silence the tongue that speaks proud against you, I call forth the armies of heaven to guard you and protect you, to lift you up and shield you completely under their wings. I decree that no snare will capture you, no sudden alarm will shake you, says the Lord in Proverbs 3 verses 25 to 26. For he who keeps you will not slumber, he who protects you will not sleep. I command every evil net and every negative word curse sent to entangle your destiny to be consumed by the fire of the Holy Spirit now in Jesus' name.
just as the snares of the wicked could not prevail against blameless David, whose shield was the Lord God Most High, I declare that no hidden trap or malicious scheme will prosper against you in Jesus' name. For who can harm you when you follow what is good and do the Lord's will? And everyone who exalts themselves against you will be brought low by the power in the name of Jesus. For the salvation of the righteous comes from the Lord, who protects them like a shield in time of trouble. I pray that the Lord shall protect you from every evil arrows in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare that God will make your righteousness shine like the dawn and your justice like the noonday. Although the wicked secretly shoot their arrows against the blameless to slay them in the darkness, their bows will all be broken in the mighty name of Jesus. I command every lying and devouring tongue targeting you to dry up from the root and wither away. Just as Goliath's threats could not prevail against young David, who came in the name of the Lord God Almighty, I silence and cut off every voice that taunts and intimidates you by demonic threats or false accusations. I decree open disgrace and divine judgment upon all who magnify themselves against you and seek your ruin. I command every proud wave striking against you, every contrary wind and stormy blast opposing your destiny, to be rebuked and laid to rest by the great I Am. Just as Jesus said, "Peace, be still," causing the winds and waves to obey his voice, I declare that all clamoring voices in the realm of the spirit resisting and raging against you shall bow in submission to the commands of the Most High God. For greater is he that is in you than anything in the world trying to destroy you. I speak over that henceforth Psalm 118 works for you as you remain surrounded and fortified on all sides, that you may boldly declare, "The Lord is for me, I will not fear. What can man do to me?" I command all intimidating spirits trying to elicit fear and anxiety to tremble and flee away from you now in Jesus' mighty name. As David overcame the lion, the bear, and the giant through his great faith in the God who delivers, I release boldness into your spirit and command every inner voice of fear, doubt, or intimidation assaulting your mind to be silent. As David encouraged himself in the wilderness, stirred himself up in God, and recovered all that was taken, I call forth a tenacious spirit of faith to rise within you, one that pursues, overtakes, and recovers all. I declare the steadfast love of the Lord upon you, his mercy and favor to preserve you. Though an army encamp around you, your heart will not fear. Though war rises against you, you will be confident in God, for even stone walls will collapse and weapons formed against you shall fail. No schemes arched in darkness shall succeed, and every lying tongue condemning you will be shown to be in the wrong. Again, may the words and the spirit behind Psalm 118 fortify and protect you on all sides. Let those who come against you be put to shame, but may you never be put to shame. Let those plotting your downfall turn back in disgrace and humiliation, but may you be uplifted and established upon the rock, Christ Jesus. I declare you are delivered forevermore from the snare of the fowler and deadly pestilence, in accordance to Psalm 91. No plague of darkness or calamity of night shall overtake your dwelling. You shall tread upon the lion and the adder, trample the young lion and serpent under your feet. As David prayed in distress and anguish for God not to be far away, I call for divine assistance and heavenly armies to surround and shield you now in Jesus' name. I decree sudden angelic support and divine intervention into your affairs. May God command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. As Elisha prayed for his servant's eyes to be opened, releasing God's greatest spiritual forces to reveal themselves, I call forth lightning flashes of divine insight and spiritual vision to illuminate your path ahead, that you may walk wisely and avoid the snares of darkness seeking to entrap you in Jesus' name. I declare that those who rise against you will fall for your sake, says the Lord in Isaiah 54 verse 15. For who dares accuse you whom the Lord has chosen? I command all tongues speaking negative words for false testimonies or malicious lies against you to dry up immediately and receive a burning coal of conviction to speak no more deceit. As Mordecai fought the wicked schemes of Haman aimed at destroying the innocent, I declare that just as a man was hung on the very gallows built for Mordecai, your enemies and accusers will receive the due rewards for their wickedness, while you shall be uplifted and established on higher ground. For the one who digs a pit will himself fall into, and like Goliath, the one who comes to accuse and terrify you will himself be struck down by the very schemes and weapons aimed at you. As Jezebel's vile threats against Elijah were overturned, and in his stead she was seized and trampled underfoot by divine judgment, I decree the same immediate intervention and vindication for you against every corrupt source seeking your downfall. Like Haman, may all who pursue bloodshed against your innocent life be precisely targeted by divine justice and recompense. For the Lord loves justice and will not abandon his faithful ones. I release a prophetic decree over your life from the heavenly courts and seal it permanently by the blood of Jesus Christ and the mighty work of the cross. What God has spoken and propose for your good cannot be reversed or overturned in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 118 stands as a divine shield and canopy of favor for all your coming and going out, surrounding you on all sides with grace and deliverance from all calamity and snares of darkness. May those who pursue and persecute you be ashamed and disgraced, but may you stand radiant with God's joy and vindication. Let deceivers and accusers bear their own shame while God's righteousness illuminates your life without apology. The Lord himself has become your salvation and sure defense. No one who condemns or contends with you shall prevail. For God is with you to deliver you, says the Lord. I seal this prayer over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let all God's angels heed this divine commission and surround you as a wall of fire and shield of faith on all sides. Greater is he who is in you than anything in all creation that strives against you. May the Lord bless and protect you always. He will send back every evil arrow aimed to kill you or your loved ones in the mighty name of Jesus. I come against any assignment embarked upon or giving of premature death targeting your life right now in the name of Jesus. I speak Psalm 118 verse 17 over your life, that you will live and not die, and declare the works and glory of the Lord in the land of the living. As David confessed, the snares of death encompassed him and torrents of destruction overwhelmed him. But in distress, he called on the Lord, who answered him and brought him into a spacious place. I declare you shall not die, but have a long life and see the goodness of the Lord to the very end. I also pray Psalm 91 over you, that you who live under the Most High and Almighty's shadow, God alone being your refuge and fortress, will be delivered from the perilous pestilence and deadly plague. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, yet it shall not come near you. No evil shall conquer you, no scourge shall overwhelm your tent. You shall witness the reward of the wicked and see God's salvation with your very eyes. Beloved child, I declare Isaiah 38 verse 5 over your life, which says, I have heard your prayer and seen your tears. I will add 15 years to your life. Receive extension and increase over your days, just as Ezekiah did. When death came knocking prematurely, the Lord shall make the sun's shadow go back 10 steps on the stairway of Ahaz. You shall yet praise him with stringed instruments all the days of your life in the temple of the Lord. I call forth Psalm 118 confessing, I shall not die but live and recount the works and wondrous words of God. Death has no claim over you, only life and peace in the spirit. The sting of death is sin, and Christ has conquered both grave and sin, sealing your eternity with his own blood. I declare the preserving power of the blood covenant, ensuring ensuring no weapon formed against you prospers and no plague destroys your dwelling. Beloved child, like Job, I stand in the gap and build a hedge of protection around you, your household, and all that pertains to you. I forbid any devil, disaster, or disease from crossing that bloodline to touching your body or life before ordained time. I dispatch angels to guard you in all your ways, bearing you up lest you dash your feet against a stone. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit encamp as a wall of fire around you. I speak supernatural reversal and repel of any death sentence or premature end spoken over your life by intention or prophecy, whether by medical verdicts, word curse, spiritual divination, or legal judgments. Like when Mordecai uncovered Haman's sinister plot to annihilate the Jews, I expose the operations of darkness and cancel their contracts. No weapon formed against you shall succeed, and you will nullify every tongue that rises against you in condemnation or curse. For you are a child of the Most High God, brought for a great and glorious purpose. I declare that Jesus came to give you life more abundantly, a rich and satisfying life, pouring out blessings into eternity. The good shepherd attends to you through death's darkest valley shadow, his rod and staff driving away all fear and despair. His table of feasts awaits in enemies' presence, his oil of joy refreshing your face. Only goodness and unfailing love pursue you always into his house forevermore. Precious child, like Lazarus, even if sickness leads to death, God shall yet have the final word and resurrection power to restore life and earth. Whether by miracle, manifestation, or through ultimate heavenly healing, deliverance shall belong to you. God shall wipe away every tear and transform ashes back to beauty again. Beloved one, I stand in agreement with the psalmist's confession in 31 verse 15, my times are in your hand. Your days, weeks, and years unfold under his sovereign design. Trust him to complete all he has started within you on this side of heaven, then welcome you joyfully home when final breath draws near in appointed time. I speak Isaiah 65 verse 20 over your life, that at 100 years you shall still bear fruit and prosper under lengthy days. Set your gaze beyond temporal troubles to the unseen eternal weight of glory prepared for you. Allow this magnificent hope to renew strength and anchor soul through storms. Nothing passes his sight. Love ever remains working all things for good for those who answer his upward call. I release resurrection life and power over areas of affliction and disease in the mighty name of Jesus. By his stripes you are healed. I forbid this sickness leading to any further foothold of infirmity or untimely death. I declare the preserving work of the great physician who heals all diseases upon you now. In Jesus' name, rise up healed, well and restored. I paralyze the activity of any deceiving spirit impersonating diseased loved ones, appearing to draw your soul out of alignment with truth or lure you into occultic practices outside God's will. I break these deceptions off your life in Jesus' name. May your feet remain steadfast on the rock as you stay rooted in scripture and covenant with Christ alone as intermediary between heaven and those on earth awaiting his return. Beloved child of destiny, I declare the shield and armor of Psalm 5 verse 12 over your life. Surely, Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with your favor as a shield. Set your gaze ahead on the joy set before you to finish your course and ministry, well and strong. Allow no people, disease, disaster, or spirit of death rob remaining years of experiencing his goodness. Stay vigilant against bitterness as God writes brightest endings born of deep trust and surrender. Yours is the kingdom in all its fullness. Walk boldly into broad places, prepare to drink deeply. Beloved child of promise, I call forth divine turnarounds over medical diagnoses declaring shortened life expectancy or disease progression leading to premature death. Receive grace, mercy, and wisdom for navigating uncharted waters ahead. May faith arise to walk on stormy seas through pain's mystery. Fix eyes on the healer's face. Nothing fails outside his redemptive plans. Where hopeless prognosis looms, God specializes in supernatural intervention, redirecting impossible outcomes. Jesus endured death, marching toward resurrection certainty. So shall you cross into greater glory through momentary light afflictions, preparing an incorruptible crown reserved for those discovering single eye vision, witness from above. Shake loose all that entangles feet from running tirelessly as one race with Christ. Detach completely from outcomes here. Reattach heart posture unto full obedience. Receive fresh download of kingdom perspectives. I seal this prayer over you in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, the resurrection and the life, by the power of his blood that has ransomed your life from destruction. I forbid any weapon formed against you to prosper now and all your days ahead. Surge forward mightily into all your good Father has prepared for you. The enemy will not prevail. You'll finish your race strong in the center of God's glorious unfolding story. Psalm 23 verses 1 to 3. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters and he refreshes my soul. Lord, you are not just a good father, but also a great shepherd. And as a great shepherd leads his sheep to peaceful pastures and quiet waters, so will you do to my spirit every time I want to lay down. In you, I know that I will find rest, and my spirit will be renewed even as I close my eyes to sleep. Nothing shall take away my sleep and peace of mind. I am safe and secure in your arms. According to the word of Psalm 121 verses 3 to 4, he will not let your foot sleep. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. Lord, in the darkest hours of the night, when I am most vulnerable and weak, I am assured that you are always watching over me, staying vigilant so that no harm will come to me. I thank you because you neither slumber nor sleep just to keep me safe. Your word shall never break, neither will you alter that which has proceeded from your mouth concerning me. According to the word of Psalm 91 verses 1 to 2, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his feathers you will find a refuge. His faithfulness shall be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Lord, you are my refuge and my fortress. Like a protective parent, like a mother hen protecting her chicks, you cover me under your feathers, shielding us from all attacks of the enemy and the terrors of the night. I don't have to be afraid because I am perpetually dwelling in your shadow. According to the word of Psalm 3 verses 5 to 6, I lie down and sleep, and I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear though 10,000s assail me on every side. I certainly will not be afraid of tens of thousands of people who gang up against me when I am asleep at night, because you, my Father, sustain me with your mighty hands. According to the word of Psalm 16 verses 7 to 8, I will praise the Lord who counsels me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. I will keep my eyes on you always, because with you at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Even when I am asleep, your counsel will remain with me. According to the word of Psalm 139 verses 11 and 12, if I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, Even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. Lord, this psalm fills me with the hope and assurance that there's nothing that happens in the dark that you don't know about. So even when the enemy tries to hide in the dark to harm me at night, you see it and you will rescue me. According to the word of Psalm 127 verse 2, in vain you rise early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat as a grand sleep to those who he loves. Lord, toiling and hard work can sometimes hinder me from sleeping, but you have made it clear that those you love, you will certainly grant sleep, because I know you love me. Psalm 46 verse 10, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted amongst the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. You have told me to be still and know that you are God. I release my burdens and anxieties to you. Please be exalted above all these and lead me to a peaceful sleep. Psalm 121 verses 5 to 8, the Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. Lord, you have promised to be my shade at my right hand, and I know that both during the day and at night, you are always watching over me. I don't have to be afraid of whatever has been programmed to the moon and to the sun to harm me. Psalm 91 verses 14 to 16, because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him, I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Lord, I call on you. Please deliver and satisfy my weary soul. Please protect me even as I lay down to sleep. And every time I call upon you, whether during the day or late at night, Lord, please answer me. According to the word of Psalm 62 verses 1 to 2, 5 to 8, truly my soul finds rest in God. My salvation comes from him. Truly he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will never be shaken. Yes, my soul finds rest in God. My hope comes from him. Truly he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He is my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in him at all times. You people, pour out your hearts to him, for God is our refuge. Lord, with you by my side, I know I will find rest for my soul. As I close my eyes, help me to trust in you that you will see me through the night, and I will wake up refreshed and restored. All these I have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for you, dear one, crying out to the great physician to bring strength and healing to your body. Though sickness, pain, or injury may ravage for a night, joy comes in the morning. Restoration is here. Therefore, I declare the Lord's verdicts over you according to Psalm 31 that says, be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who wait for the Lord. Today, divine health and wellness permeates into every cell of your body in the name of Jesus. I command your bones, tissues, organs, and systems to come into alignment with God's original design for you. Receive the Creator's touch over your frame. He formed you wonderfully and knows how to realign anything amiss. I call forth the revival of life to flow through you from head to toe right now. Where there was weakness, catastrophe, or deterioration, I declare newness of life by the Holy Spirit. He makes all things new, so I say, cells regenerate, inflammation subsides, nerves reconnect, and fibers mend under heaven's healing rays. Be made whole. I declare by faith that you are already healed by the stripes Jesus took upon his back, according to 1 Peter 2 verse 24. That includes every emotional, spiritual, and physical wound you carry. Christ bore your sickness so you can bear his healing. I call for the manifestation into the nature of what he finished at the cross. Health and wellness permeate you now from crown to soul. I decree the words of Psalm 103 over your life, who forgives all your iniquity, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy. Every condition stemming from generational curses, personal sin, and trauma is cleansed by the blood of Jesus. I declare your body healed and delivered. I command all infections and infirmities to leave your body now in Jesus' name. Receive supernatural antibiotics attacking every virus and harmful bacteria according to Luke 13 verse 12. Crippled hands are released. Restored vision and hearing. Every missing limb will be replaced as you continue to seek the Lord in faith. I call forth divine restoration of robbed health and lost years. What the enemy meant to destroy through affliction will become testament of God's goodness. The Lord balances every scale, tilting favor and blessing your way. As with Job, He will bless your latter days even more than your former. Receive abundantly above all that you can ask or imagine. I declare that through faith and patience, you will inherit every promise of God. Do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward. Persevere in prayer and stand on His word. Though healing takes time, His Spirit brings comfort, hope, and strength for the journey. It will bring it to pass right on schedule. I decree divine connections leading you to people to bring breakthroughs, whether supernatural healing or practical help through medicine and physicians. Receive it. Let no pride or false doctrine block what God wants to do. His methods are infinite, His healing often gradual. Hold fast to His hand through the process. Wellness awaits. I command all genetic weaknesses that empower sickness to bow to the name of Jesus, reversed by His healing blood. Jesus bore our sicknesses and carried our pains so we can walk in divine health and wholeness. By His stripes, you will be made whole. Spirit, soul, and body, I call forth inner healing and deliverance from trauma, abuse, loss, and grief that opened us to sickness. Holy Spirit, take us back to access painful memories this child of God carries. Come as the comforter, bringing perspective and cleansing. Exchange pain for joy, mourning for gladness. Beloved, see the Lord's goodness in your affliction. He promised to use all things to work together for our good as we submit to His working. What the enemy meant for harm, God turns to holiness as we yield trials to Him. Our light afflictions now achieve eternal glory. This test will give tremendous testimony up ahead. Through this sickness and suffering, God develops perseverance, character, and hope in you. You will shine as an overcomer, displaying His victory and faithfulness. The trials of many will be comforted through your journey. His strength is shown perfect through human weakness and need. Ask Him for grace to rejoice in this divine process. I declare that nothing separates you from the love of Christ, not even pain and infirmity, according to Romans 8, verses 35 to 39. If He ordains for this thorn to remain, take heart. His power rests upon you. His strength is made perfect in weakness. Ask Him for sufficient grace to carry out the cross and sufficient faith to believe still for healing. He is worthy of praise in it all. I decree that those who sow in tears will reap with shouts of joy. Though healing tarries, take heart, dear one. God collects every tear, filling His bottle of remembrance. None fall fruitless to the ground. He will turn weeping into gladness, sickness to health. On that day, none will be able to curse, for He makes all things new. I command every negative word, curse, lie, or accusation sent your way to dissolve under the power of God's word and the healing blood of Jesus. Let no word of death take root in your body. Cast down thoughts that exalt themselves above the knowledge of Christ. Stand on His finished work at the cross with patience and confidence, knowing that He will bring it to pass. I call forth a new habitation place for His Spirit to dwell. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead comes to fortify your body as a temple of the living God. What was damaged or defiled is fully restored. Receive strength beyond your own to walk out this healing daily through His enabling grace. You are more than a conqueror through Christ. Beloved child of God, behold the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Set your gaze upon the One who heals. The spirit within brings life to your mortal body as a down payment of future glory. Allow his resurrection power to flow freely to every place needing restoration. You shall live and not die. Wholeness is here. I declare that you are no longer under the curse of the law, but redeemed to receive Abraham's blessings. Christ has redeemed you from sickness, poverty, spiritual death, and the curse of sin that plagues this fallen world. Receive everlasting life and wholeness in the eternally secured inheritance of God's children. I decree deliverance from spirits of infirmity that empower sickness and disease according to Luke 13 verse 12. Receive freedom in mind and body now from all effects of trauma, substance abuse, and chronic conditions keeping you weighed down this many years. What Holy Spirit is reviving cannot be bound up again. I command all negative soul ties feeding darkness to be severed now by the sword of the Spirit. Receive deep spiritual cleansing as the Holy Ghost fire burns through roots of iniquity passed down generationally. The sins, trauma, and twisted covenants of the fathers and mothers dissolve under the blood of Jesus. You are free. I call forth spiritual biomarkers revealing the root causes of symptoms and conditions plaguing you. Holy Spirit, unveil hidden sources feeding this affliction, whether trauma, generational curses, environmental toxins, or lifestyle choices keeping darkness empowered. Grant wisdom and strategies for walking in the grant wisdom and strategies for walking in divine health. I declare that death and sickness have lost their sting since Christ conquered sin and the grave. Though this body may waste away, you have an eternal house prepared by God, not built by human hands. His resurrection life lifts you beyond mortal constraints of deterioration, sickness, and aging. I decree that those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength as eagles. As you wait on him for healing and breakthrough, equip yourself through studying the healing covenants and promises of God. Read testimonies of saints who persevered by faith and prayer to receive. Ask for fresh fire to stand through every hardship along the way. I command all lingering generational illnesses stemming from familiar spirits to be severed at the roots now by God's healing word. Causes of cancer, disorders, heart diseases, and early death be reversed and lifted by the blood of Jesus Christ. Step into generational blessings of longevity and divine health prepared for you. I call forth hunger in you for Christ, the true bread of life. As you feed deeply on his living word, revelation and intimacy grows with God. Receive fresh perspective, shifting focus from symptoms and limitations onto the healer himself. He sanctifies every struggle, using trials to unveil more of his glorious nature. Rest in his abiding presence, filling you now. Beloved, though flesh and heart fail, God remains the strength of your heart eternally. When faith or patience runs low, cry out to him for fresh oil to persevere. Worship the healer even from this pit. Allow his spirit to come forth and carry hope, restoring joy and vision bit by bit. He walks divinely through each season when you yield all to him. I declare that those who honor God, he will honor. Humble yourself under his mighty hand, and in due time he will exalt you with wholeness, healing, and a new life. Take on the heart of a servant, leaning to love, compassion, and kindness for others while standing for your healing. This brings breakthrough upon breakthrough. I decree that you will live and not die, and declare the works of the Lord, as Psalm 118 verse 17 declares. Even if he ordains more waiting, know that God holds your life secure in his hands. He remains intimately close as your soul's high tower. Let him hold your heart gently as you wait patiently on his perfect will. I command all delays, setbacks, and hindrances against healing to be removed now in Jesus' mighty name. Whether spirits of affliction, lack of resources, or revelation, I declare the way clear for divine turnaround. As you take steps forward, Lord, meet this child of God with demonstration of your power according to your word. Breakthrough is here now. I call forth lasting freedom from addiction and perversion, opening the door to recurring affliction. Receive merciful release from self-medication, ungodly relational bonds, and practices defiling the temple of God's Spirit. Trade shame and secrecy for healing as Christ's light permeates hidden places of pain. Go and sin no more, says the healer who makes all things new. I join you in praise to God, child of God. Rejoice, you are made completely whole. Receive strength in your bones and joy unspeakable shining through each day. Victory, health, and favor surround you. Worship the Lord with all that is within you, for he has delivered you from the pit and crowned you with loving kindness. Surely his goodness and mercy follow you all the days of your life. You are healed forevermore. Amen.